I can't believe what I'm seeing. The great Mozart himself. When will we have the good fortune of seeing you play The Marriage of Figaro in Prague?
If it stays between you and I can confess that the Emperor didn't really like it. To perform Figaro here would seem quite inappropriate.
Wolfgang, can I ask you for a favor?
Certainly. What can I do for you?
Wolfgang, would you accept to sign my little book of autographs?
Of course. I'd be honored.
To my number one fan. There. Right by the autograph of Handel. If I remember well, you were 12 years old the first time I saw you performing.
What a remarkable performance, Mozart, sir. I believe you appreciated the show they put on. My best friends and I have just sat through the performance of your new opus.
Oh, really? What did you think about it?
The piece reminded me of that old charming Italian musician. Do you remember him?
Vivaldi? He was Venetian, that's for sure. But I'm not sure I see your drift.
Don't pretend to be so naive, Mozart. I am sure you draw your inspiration from one of the melodies composed by the old Antonio.
Certainly not, madam. What you say is bordering on insult.
I didn't mean it, Mozart. I am but your fondest admirer, be sure of it. Mozart, please excuse my foolhardiness, but would you give me those ribbons on your jacket?
Madam, excuse me, but I have to refuse. I don't give away that kind of souvenir.
Please, just give me a little something.
Would a smile content you?
Of course not, dear Mozart. I'd like to know the real name of the commander in Don Giovanni. That is the prize I want you to give me.
Very well. I can reveal that the name of the commander is Leopold.
Leopold? Your father's name? I know a doctor in Vienna that you should see. He'd help you sort out the origins of your inspiration.
Thanks for suggesting it. Still, God is the sole origin of my inspiration.
What a remarkable performance, Mozart, sir. I believe you appreciated the show they put on.
I knew the Kapellmeister would have kept a few treats in his box.
You're here quite late, Mozart. Also, I wonder why my husband is not home. I'm tired of waiting for him.
Didn't you find the people surrounding your husband lately a bit suspicious?
Johann hangs out with all kinds of people, and most of them are vulgar.
Did you notice any new faces around him lately?
the same as always, except for that Keller and a Prussian guy whose name I don't know.
Hasn't he met Keller? What did they say to each other?
I don't eavesdrop on Keller or my husband's conversations. Still, I hope that Johann has not become some kind of informant for the police. That would be awful.
And why?
Because he could report us. No, I'm just joking.
Alexa, I am in dire need. I have to get the money Johann owes me urgently.
What money, my dear?
The share he promised me on Don Giovanni's grosses.
I could lead you inside my husband's office, but in order to do it, you would have to give me a strong incentive.
How? Tell me. I would forever be in your debt.
I am so attracted to you. Still, I doubt you'll accept it.
I certainly wouldn't want to tarnish your honor of a married woman, dear Alexa.
My honor? But this would be but a glorious mission for me.
I'm not sure I understand.
Mozart, it's quite simple. I want a part in your next opera.
That's it? But certainly, I'd be delighted, on the condition that you consent to submit yourself to a few rehearsals. We can make a first try immediately, if you wish.
I seem to have a dryness in my throat. Could you prepare a bit of warm water with some honey so I can clear it up?
Your wish is my command. I need to find something to get the fire burning under the kettle.
Mozart, it is so late. I feel dizzy. Still, every moment I spend with you is so exciting. What a nice intention. That's exactly what I need to clear my throat. I feel much better. Now order me, and I'll do my best to please you.
There's a vocal piece I've been thinking about for some time. I'd like to hear you sing it.
Something new? That's even more exciting.
It is, but it's also a bit challenging. It goes something like this.
What a charming tune. I hope I can do it justice, Maestro. I am all yours.
Thank you.
That was perfect. Your voice, combined with your beauty, just make you some kind of divinity. I'll dream about you when I compose my next opera.
Mozart, your flattery makes my head spin. So be it. I give up. The key to Johann's office is hidden under the bust of a German musician. I will say no more. Find the key, bring it to me, and I'll open the office for you. Thank you, my dear. I'll open the door for you and keep watch to make sure nobody shows up. I'll put the key back in its place later on.
I saw everything.
Oh, so you can talk.
I don't talk, but I sure can listen.
What you just said contradicts your very words.
If you had a brain the size of a nut, you would have understood me.
You seem very sharp, Papageno. Would you like a part in one of my operas?
A part? Talk to my agent.
Oh, you'll be compensated for your trouble. We'll most certainly find you some kind of present that'll make you happy.
Papageno, the books are notes. F-E-A-G-C.
The libretto of Lorenzo da Ponte for The Marriage of Figaro. Without his wits and understatements, the emperor would have banned such an irreverent material. A bottle with extracts of autumn crocus. Haufer believes this cheap medicine can help him with his aching joints. Myself, I sure don't need it. That's some kind of summary. And so far, it's useless. Ledgers with tags. Ledgers with tags. Ledgers with tags.